Hey everyone, this is Abhinendra from CG Artist Academy and I'm back with a new tutorial. It's a short tutorial about how to create inflatable objects in Maya with the help of Maya and Cloth Solvers. So let's get started. So I have a scene in there. This is a chips packet and we are gonna create it like an inflatable object. With the help of this tutorial, you can create any object with the inflatable look and feel. Okay, so this is selected. Go to your FX settings here, FX tab. Okay, and in this, create end cloth. Select create cloth. Just it. You somehow you are almost done with the, so it's selected and let's go to the nucleus. Select this option, use plane, so it will treat this grid as a plane. Okay, so let's see plane. Now you can see it's already on the base, but it's intersecting each other like its faces. Okay, so to prevent that, we need to change few settings in end cloth. Select this end cloth. You can see over here that collisions. Open it. We have this option. Solver display. Select on collision thickness. So now you can see what is the thickness volume we have over here. So we can control it by this thickness. So if I increase this like 0.60, okay, and if you want to see this, you can see this. You can increase like this. For starters, I am using only this. 060. It's a collision thickness, and for the cell collision, we have already this much scale of spheres, but we need to increase that also so that they will not penetrate each other. Okay, so let's switch it off and with the start frame, select this end cloth. Go to your end cache, create new cache, an object, select your path, like in my case it's here, cache version 003, and select the folder and create. So now you can see that it's already simulated and it's not penetrating anymore. So that's how you can prevent your intersection of meshes. Sorry. So if I enable this collide, so what it does is, so when this is enabled, EndCloth object collides with passive objects and EndCloth objects or other EndCloth objects that share the same Maya nucleus solver. And when it's off like this, it doesn't collide with any passive objects or end particle objects. And if you enable self collide, your end cloth object collides with its own output mesh. So now we have a collision flags. There are three collision flags that specify, like if you selected vertex, collision occurs at the collision space that surround each of the EndCloth vertices, and if that edge option is selected, collision occurs at the collision cylinders that surround each of the EndCloth edges, and if the faces is selected, the collision occurs at the collision surface that is offset from the EndCloth face. So for this simulation, I am using faces. Now, another one is cell collision flag. So with this cell collision flag, you can use these options like vertex, vertex edges, face, vertex face, and full surface. Okay, this is a very short tutorial. I'm not going to demonstrate everything. So let's quickly go to this thickness. So the thickness is, it specifies the radius or depth of the encloth object's collision volumes. Encloth collision volumes are actually not renderable surfaces offset from the encloth vertices, edges or faces. Maya Nucleus Solver uses when calculating self collision or passive object collisions. So the collision occurs at the encloth collision volumes, not at the surface of the encloth object itself. And thickness also determines how thick your encloth appears. Okay, so now self collide width scale. Okay, this is specify a self collision scale value for the encloth object. Self collide width scale allows you to scale an enclosed object meshes thickness to improve self collisions. This is especially useful with vertex self collision to make the self collide spheres overlap without requiring too great a width. So you can see now my cloth is already settled over here and I already cached it. So this is the my position I am going to use for my initial state, like the for the beginning. So go to this field and solvers, go to initial state and select this one, select set for the selected. Okay, so sorry, because it's already cached, I need to cache it again. So, or maybe I can delete my cache. So let's delete it. And yeah, so you can see that now it's already cached. One more thing I can do is before I go to inflate this, select this encloth properties, go to your pressure settings. From here you can inflate your objects. So let's start to inflate the object. Select your encloth and down over here go to this pressure setting. We have two options in here, like manual pressure setting and other one is volume pressure setting. For this I'm going to use this manual pressure setting. So what we can do is increase the pressure setting with the keyframes. So on 0 or maybe till 15 frame it will be 0, set key, and till 50 I'll be needing to increase this, and till 70 I'll be using the same setting, like 1, again set a key, and till 85 I want it to be 0. So that's it. Let's simulate it. So go to your first frame. Okay, one more thing I need to do is in the nucleus setting I'm gonna have some air, increase the wind noise. So I'll be using like 2 for this, and I need air in my minus y axis. Okay, 0 minus 1. Okay, so wind speed maybe like 2, I don't want more. Let's simulate again. Select the cloth, go to cache, new cache, and create, replace. Yeah, and it's already started. So now that caching is done, so you can see how it's working. You can play with the settings and get more interesting results. It's all up to you how you play with the settings. So we can add some more air in this to get another look and feel, because it's up to you. I have also created another inflatable object. Let me show you. This is another example of which I have did with this same effect, like inflatable object to get this look on this shoe. I find this very interesting, so I thought I should share this with you. This is a very simple technique. It's very easy to use. You can play with the settings and get whatever the results you want to. It's all about playing with the settings. I hope you guys find this tutorial helpful, and I will definitely try to make new tutorials, more tutorials for you, like short tutorials, because they will help you in your daily production work or whatever R&D you are doing. So thank for your time, guys, and please do share this video if you like it, and follow my tutorials, subscribe my page. Thanks for your support, and thanks for watching.